Welcome to Engineers Academy. Subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to receive the notification for the upcoming videos.
Today we are going to solve this problem 272. So in this problem it is said that a force F of magnitude 15 Newton. So this is a force F of magnitude 15 Newton making 20 degrees with the vertical is exerted on the automobile parking brake lever at the position this X 250 mm. So this X is equal to 250 mm. So we need to replace the force by an equivalent force coupled system at pivot point O. So the requirement is that we need to replace this 50 Newton force by a force coupled system at this point O. So let me draw the free body diagram for this problem. Now if this is, let's suppose, that point O, and let's suppose that this is that parking brake lever, right? So it is said that this part of the lever from this point, let's suppose I say that this point is X, this point is, let's suppose, Y, right? So let's suppose we say that this part of the lever, let's suppose that this is YB, right? So this YB portion of the lever is making 15 degrees with this OY portion, right? So this is 15 degrees, this is given. And similarly, it is also given that this YB portion of the lever is making 10 degrees with the horizontal, right? So if I draw a horizontal line here, so this is given that this is 10 degrees, right? So now as we can see, if we want to find the angle of this part of the lever, right? So if this is a horizontal line, so this angle will be the summation of these two, right? So as we can see that this and this, right? So 10 plus 25, so this means that OY part of the lever is 25 degrees with the horizontal, right? So now if I draw that force, so this is that force at some point making 20 degrees with the vertical. So let's suppose if this is that force, this is 20 degrees, right? So let me write 20 degrees. So now if I resolve this force into its components, right, we need to find the moment of this force, this 50 Newton force about this point O, in order to replace this force by a force coupled system, right? So what we will do, let me resolve this force into its components. So one of the component is in this direction, right, and the other component will be in this direction. So these will be the two components of this. Let's suppose, so this vertical component will be the cos component, so it will be F cos of 20 degrees, and this component will be F sine of 20 degrees, right? So to find the moment about point O, so we need to find the perpendicular distance of F cos of 20 component, and we also need to find the perpendicular distance of this sine component, right? So now if I extend the line of action of this component, this cos component, right? So this will be the perpendicular distance. So let's suppose if this is D1, right? So this D1 will be the perpendicular distance of this cos component, right? So let me find this D1 first. So as we can see that this angle is 25 degree, right? So this will be, let's suppose if I resolve this length, so this length, let's suppose this is y dash, right? And similarly, this will be equal to this length, right? So let's suppose that this is, let's suppose, P1, so this is P2, right? So D1 will be equal to P1 plus P2, right? So P1 is the cos component of OY, and this is given, this is 100 mm, right? So P1 is 100 cos of 25 degrees. Similarly, P2. So P2 is the cos component of YB, right? So this length is how much? This is 250, this X, this is given. So the YB length, the YB, this is that point B, right? So this YB length is given, this is X, so it is 250 mm, so it will be 250 cos of 10 degrees, right? So this will be D1, And similarly, the perpendicular distance of this component, let's suppose this is that sine component, so it is f sine of 20 degrees. So the perpendicular distance of this sine component from the point O is this length, this much, right? So let's suppose if that is d2, right? So then d2 will be equal to this length and this length, right? So it will be 100 sine of 25 degrees plus 250 sine of 10 degrees, right? So this will be d2. So let me calculate this. So now when we solve this, so d1 comes out to be 336.83 mm, d2 comes out to be 85.67 mm, right? So now to find the moment about O, so we will use the Vairignan's theorem, right? So this is the Vairignan's theorem. We have resolved this force into its components. So we will find the moment of the individual components and then we will take the sum, right? So now I will write F cos of 20 degrees into its perpendicular distance, right? So the perpendicular distance of the cos component is d1, right? And as we can see that this is producing counterclockwise moment, right? And this one is also producing counterclockwise moment. So let's suppose that this is positive, right? Counterclockwise moment is positive. So I will write plus f sine of 20 degrees and I will multiply this with d2, right? So the perpendicular distance of sine component from the axis of rotation is d2. So we will write, and if we take F common, so F is 50 Newton, so it will be 50 cos of 20 d1, so d1 is 336.83 divided by 1000 plus sine of 20 degrees into d2, so it is 85.67 divided by 1000. Right, so when we solve this, we get moment about O. So this comes out to be 17.29 Newton meter, right, and the direction is counterclockwise. Now, in order to replace this force by its equivalent force coupled system, so what we will do, we will draw a force here at this point O, so one in the opposite direction, right? So one will be in this direction exactly parallel to that F and the other one will be in this direction, right? So this, the magnitude of both is F, that is 50 Newton, right? So this is F and this is also F, right? So as we can see that this force is counterclockwise, right? So as we can see that this F and this F, they are producing counterclockwise moment, so they will reduce this couple, right? So if we remove these two forces, so if now I remove these, let's suppose if I remove this, so now we will replace these by this counterclockwise moment at this O, right? So I will draw this arrow like this, right? So the magnitude of this will be how much? So it will be 17.29 Newton meter, right? So if we remove this force, so then this will be the required force couple system at point O, right? And the magnitude of this force is 50 Newton, right? And if someone asks that what should be the angle of this force with the positive x-axis, right? So let's suppose if we want to find that angle as well, that what is the angle of this force with the positive x-axis, right? So what is this angle? So as we can see here, if I draw a horizontal line here, right? So this is 90. 90 plus 20, so 90 plus 20 is 110, right? So I will write that if we replace this force with a force couple system, so moment will be equal to this and the force will be equal to 50 Newtons and theta with positive x-axis is equal to 90 plus 20 should be equal to 110 degrees. Right, so this is the solution of this problem.